Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print factorials of each natural number with the help of C program. So here you can see we need to print this kind of series in vertical form, or you can also print it horizontally. That depends upon the requirement. So first we need to print one factorial, then two, then three, then four, and then five, and then so on. So first we are going to read a value from user, that is n, like how many times you want to print those factorials. So if user enters, let's say n is 10, so we need to print a factorial from starting 1 to 10. So 1 to 10 all digits factorial number we need to print on output screen. So I'm going to explain this implementation with the help of C program. Before starting, if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can go to detail or description of this video, where you will find links of various playlists, so you can watch them. Now I am going to write the program so that we can have this kind of output. So I am starting from main. So one variable I will be required, then n and f, which will be having calculated factorial. Now I am going to read value of n. So n will be stored, the value of n will be stored inside n variable so that we can iterate the loop. Now here I am going to write a loop which will repeat n times, and inside this loop I have to calculate factorial, and then immediately I need to print that factorial. So printf will come inside for loop because I need to print various outputs. So here I am writing this, and so output will be like this: 1, then x factorial, then 2 x factorial, then 3 x factorial. So this way I am going to print output so that you can see the natural number is what and its factorial is what. So backslash n percent d equals to percent d, then I and f. So this way, this is the logic. Then I am closing these curly braces. So this way, this program is completed. Now I am going to explain how this will work. So let's say n is 5. We need to print these 5 outputs. So here I am going to print the output. So n is 5, I is starting from 1, and f is also 1. So that is available in the starting. Now calculate this, f into I. So 1 into 1, f will be 1. Now we need to print. So percent d, this percent d will be replaced by value of I. This percent d will be replaced by value of f. So on output screen, this will be printed, 1 equals to 1. So left hand side 1 is natural number, and right hand side 1 is its factorial. Then I will be incremented, so it will become 2. Now multiply this, f is 1, I is 2. So 2 into 1, new value of f will be 2. So this time output will be 2 equals to 2, because I is also 2 and f is also 2. Then I will be incremented, so its value is 3. Now calculate this, f is 2, I is 3. So new value of f will be 6. So again, result will be printed. So factorial of 3 is 6. So that is printed correctly. Then I will be incremented. Sorry. I will be incremented to 4. Now calculate this. F is 6. I is 4. So 6 into 4 is 24. That will be stored inside F. So right now, I is 4 and F is 24. So these two values will be printed. 4 equals to 24. So 4 is natural number and its factorial is 24. Then I will be incremented. So it is 5. So f is 24, I is 5. So the result will be 120. That is available in f. Now print both. So I is 5 and f is 120. So that is factorial of 5. So this way the series will be printed on output screen with the help of this printf. If you want only factorials, so you can print f. If you want both, natural numbers along with their factorials, you can use this printer that I demonstrated. So I hope this is very easy to understand how I calculated factorial of each natural number. If you increase the value of n, so it will repeat that particular time, and those outputs will be printed on output screen. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video, and this was very easy. You can implement it in your laptop so that you can understand it well. If you want to print it horizontally, you can remove this backslash n, so it will be printed on a single line. So I hope you understood whatever I explained. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel and go to playlist. So do watch them so that you can understand programming well. Thank you for watching this video.